Salvage specialist Drew Pritchard is in Lower Weedon in Northamptonshire at Neville Griffiths Antiques.
This is like architectural salvage Disneyland.
I don't know if that's...
No, in a good way.
Drew wants this rare Art Nouveau bed, but will his offer be enough to tempt Neville?
I'm going to do something rotten now. I'm going to give you a bid on it.
You give me a bid. Don't be silly.
I don't often do that.
No, but don't...
I'm not going to be silly.
No.
350.
That is silly.
I like your honesty.
Have you looked at it and swear? 450. You will not buy that bed anywhere.
It's just beds. I'd never have any luck with it. You know, when you buy something that just
doesn't
knocks
even have
you.
To be a bed. That could divide could a wall. It could be a screen in the middle of a...
It'll just look like a bed in the middle of a room.
No, it wouldn't.
It would.
I think...
That 400 you could, is a fair price.
I think 400 is... You're having a good deal if you get it at 400. But you've made me a bit depressed because you've not really noticed much. 425 and it's
I have
yours.
Noticed loads.
425.
425.
Right, that'll do.
Thank you. I bought something I never really buy. And it's an old bed, and I think it's a continental bed, and it's in really nice condition as well, and it's very unusual. And the one good thing about it is it's the right width. It's a modern width. Most of the old ones were very narrow.
Oh, fancy selling that bed for 425 quid.
I'm actually selling it. Why have I just bought a bed for 425 quid?
Yeah, well, that's... I've never done any good with lights.
Oh, really?
No,
the
anything
that really works out for me, to be honest.
It gets broken.
This opaline pendant light was made in the UK in the 1920s. The reading pattern on the shade makes it an unusual find. It could be worth £200.
Yeah, look, that's a nice old one, isn't it?
Yeah. How much is that, Nev?
I don't know. You tell me. Don't have to be silly on it.
No, what I normally pay is 400. What I'd normally pay, trade, for one of these would be a fair price, would be 40 quid.
I knew you were going to knock Mallow off the end.
I was, yes. Yes, I was wrong
you,
there.
400 quid is a big drop.
There was quite... Yeah, 40 quid.
Yeah, that'll be good.
Deal, thank you. Something we buy all the time, lights, got thousands of them, £40. So that's what we pay for them in that condition. Nice, easy purchase, will sell quickly. Right, T, don't break it.
How many bits do you want it in when we get back?
Just one, please.
Just one bit, okay.
Just the one piece.
There's one last thing Neville wants to show Drew.
Yeah, you've got some nice bits in it, Nev. So, this. It's an arbor.
It's a fruit arch, rose arch. Came from a big country house garden.
What age was the house?
It was a Regency house. This is a rare thing.
It is. Have you got all of it?
I've got all I've got here, yes.
There's more there, isn't there?
Yeah, I think there's about 17.
17?
Lengths.
Let's pull these two out. Right, that's that. We've got the bottom here.
Yep. While you're doing that, I'll go and get some of the spheres.
All right.
That's that.
Like that, yeah?
Yeah.
Is that really what I think it is? You know, I thought it can't be. It must be some sort of estate fencing or something.
Yeah.
Ooh, exciting tea. Ah, OK.
I say spheres, they're not. They're
like
casting.
Like a collet.
Yeah, it's a casting.
These wrought iron rose arches date from around 1820. They would have been used to display and support flowers or fruit plants in a country house garden. If the complete arch is intact, it could be worth £4,500.
How much for the lot?
1,500 quid and no deal, no knockdown. That's the best price I'll give you.
Sold. Love that, thank you very much.
But you might have to get some of these cast.
That's all right. Superb. That's what I want to find every day.
Well, if you
and
find
I won't
it...
I
will
find
you...
that every day.
I would bet you the same amount of money you won't find another one.
I won't find another one. Right, better get in there, haven't we?
Yeah.
Which ones do you want to do first, T?
Do that lot first, and then we've got a space to do then.
Let's do it.
With the deal done, Drew has to claim his prize. And that means untangling the remaining arches from the undergrowth.
When we start pulling it out, and Neville's going, there's 17 of those. Well, I thought there were 17 individual sections. There's not the 17 arches. So that makes it roughly 120 foot long. It's a rare item and a star item. You don't often get them. Roll
it
to me.
Roll it to you.
OK. I'll let you do it.
Got no handle on it now, just to make it safer.
Thank you.
I think when we get back to the office after this week's travels, they're going to probably be confronted with one of the weirdest batches of stuff we've ever bought. And do you know what? I really like that.
You've been clearing this for years, so they'll be happy. It's a love affair with all this stuff. You fall out of love with it because you've had it such a long time, but as soon as somebody shows interest, you're back in love again. So you have to have a balance, but once it's gone, it's gone, and I'm quite happy to see things go. And it's been a bit of fun.
Financially, today has been good, but it won't be good quickly. It'll be good in a month. Not everything can be turned around fast.
I weigh a bit when you...
We then bought an Opaline Light. We're always able to sell those. Easy sale for that one. Bit of work, but extremely satisfying, and we're going to save something really quite beautiful and rare.
Come on the telly.
Yep.
Drew's bought some things which I didn't even know I had. But the good thing is, he recognised that I have some really good things here. To some people, this is just a pile of junk. But to others, like he said, it's an architectural Disneyland. Thanks very much.
Fantastic.
I'll call in on you.
And so good to meet you at last.
And I want to buy off you.
Thank you.
I want the same deals.
Yeah, yeah. And good luck. When this auction happens, I'll be here.
Good. I'll let you know.
You get the same deal if you cut all the brambles in his yard.
Thanks, Nev.
Thanks.
See
you.
Bye.
Oh! Just in time for the rain.
Hey?
Hey?
Didn't know I'd be doing horticulture when we were collecting stuff.
Indiana tea. But no, a good day. Neville, top bloke.
Yep.
I like him. I like him a lot. We've got a full van. There's profit in all of them we got. But no, back to the office and see what they all got to say.